Welcome to the compilation of the steepest climbs in Adelaide in a row. I haven't got all of them in here, but we've got three in a row, which are incredibly hard. We've got Gill Terrace, which we're going up now. Then we have Sherwood. Then we have Tregarthen. No, it's Tregarthen. It's something. Anyway, it begins with T. It's a super hard climb with a very steep drive. So you can see Dan's ahead of me. Nicole was just descending on the right-hand side of the road, and we're already getting up to some steep gradients, and I'm limited gearing, to say the least, very limited gearing. I'm on the 3628. Yes, my 32 still doesn't work. But anyway, you can't really complain too much. It was a super hot day, actually. It was like 30, 34, even at like 10 o'clock in the morning. So we got out pretty early. So yeah, just don't kill me on my cadence. Like, I know it's quite bad. But here we're going 8Ks an hour with a cadence of 50 at about 300 watts. So anyone who's like, 3628 is fine for Adelaide, it's not really at all, especially if you're not super fast. Like, I'm not crazily fast, but I can put some alright power out for some time, and I'm still struggling on a lot of these climbs. But you can see here, 50 cadences, it's not very comfortable really at all. Like, for short periods it can be alright, but you'll see later on this video when we go up this ridiculous drive, which averages like 26% or 23% for like 200-300 meters, no joke, it's maybe 100 meters. I have to start zigzagging across the road, and then you get down to like 15-16%, you're like, oh, it's not too bad. Like, your perceptions of gradient change massively when you do these suddenly super steep climbs. But this ride was part of it was 50 kilometers with 2,000 meters of elevation, which is just quite frankly ridiculous. If you think about the average gradient, that means it's like literally has an average gradient of 4%, so which is just crazy. Like, it's like going uphill for 4% for 50k, but not really, because you have these 20% ramps, and then you have these ridiculous descents as well. Some of the descents are really sketchy. So you can see when my hands are coming forward, that means I'm trying to get some more weight on the front wheel so I don't basically end up falling over backwards. But here's still not too bad, but you can imagine trying to Everest this. Imagine actually trying to Everest this. It would just be horrible. You have to get some real short, small gearing, like 2240, I think Harley ran. But that's just crazy. I actually couldn't imagine Everesting this. I mean, it's quite efficient in terms of distance and whatever, because obviously you're going such, you're not doing very many Ks, but it would just be so tiring. So here I'm like, oh yeah, we going straight on. And he's like, yes. And then you can't really see on the so much, but you'll just see that it just kicks up so steep. Like, even here we're still doing like, it's still like 14%. It just doesn't look that steep. I think maybe it's a little bit off the gradient, because here is like pretty flat, but just look what's coming up. It's absolutely horrible. I don't think I've ever this is the closest I think I've ever come to walking up a hill. Well, in the last like 2 years I started probably cycling, it was just disgustingly steep, and I just had the worst gears. Like, because you've already done like a decent amount at low cadence, so your legs are already going, because we already went out Mount Osmond and Sunnyside, which is the other side of this, and it gets up to 23%, and you're like, 24%, you're like, ah, this hurts so much. Some people say it gets up to 30%, but I didn't get that, 25%, and like, until you've done 26%, or whatever it was 26 for a second, at 40 cadence, at 360 watts, you can't really, like, comprehend how painful that is. Like, there's just no way of explaining it. It's like, for most people, just going absolutely full gas and then just on purpose turning it in your biggest gear. I mean, it's just horrible. It's actually disgusting. Descending, I thought we were going to go all the way up, but the descending, I like end up waiting ages at the top and then descended down. But it was terrifying descent. You can see my speed's like 10Ks an hour, because my brake pads are a bit worn and I have carbon wheels, and I'm just like, oh my god, this is terrifying. I really didn't want to crash or anything, but, and the road surface here is pretty bad, but that was absolutely horrible. Like, it's like you're weightlifting or like squatting, because it's literally like one leg goes forward and then you push the other one up forward and then the next one. It's just, oh god, it's not nice. But it's like, these climbs are just so much fun to do. I actually just love just going up the steepest thing you can find and just going up, because you've got that resistance. Like, obviously, so this session was supposed to be just me doing tempo efforts, but I was like, why do tempo efforts up like 5% gradients when I can just do tempo efforts at 50 cadence up like 15-20% gradients? So here is pretty flat now. Like, when I was riding this, I was like, oh my god, we are zooming along, we are flying, and then realized we're going like 20 k's an hour. I was like, ah, Nope. It's just we were going 8 k's an hour. It's like when you're going from 20 k's an hour to like 40 k's an hour, or even more, 20 k's an hour to 50 k's an hour. It suddenly feels like you're going a big speed difference. That's the same here. It's going from like 5% gradient to a 25% gradient. I mean, it's like it changes quite a lot. But anyway, I'm just cruising at this point because I know we got a long way to go. This course was basically backloaded. At the beginning, we did like some which were further south, and then we basically went north and did like Coach, Woodlands Way, part of Euro Norton's Ridgeland Drive, I think it's called. They're just horrible climbs. And anyway, so basically, we then skip ahead to Sherwood Terrace, which is this climb now. We basically just waited around about for Nicole, which was cool. And then we went up this, which was, again, absolutely horrible. Like, it wasn't the worst, just because it only really reared up at the very end. But even here, you can see it's like 12%. Like, the thing with these climbs is, like, well, even watching the GoPro, or even riding up, you just forget, like, how steep certain things are. And you sort of forget, like, the actual, just, I don't know, you've seen your perception of gradient obviously changes so much. So that you just feel, I don't know, you feel like going up these 13% ramps aren't too much, and then when it kicks up to 15, you're like, oh, it's not too bad. But the thing is, when you're riding, like, you don't really look at your cadence or anything, but, like, looking now, you're like, oh my god, 50 cadence, like, that is incredibly painful. But, like, doing it, I was like, well, it's not that bad, like, but maybe it was just because I was doing, well, 30 or 40 cadence before. But even so, like, you really do need bigger gears. I think if I had a 36, 32, that would probably be fine, but I should have gone for the 34. 36, 34 is the same as a 34, 32. So Dan's on a 34, 32. And he was struggling, but not that much, just because he has, like, effectively two easier gears than me. Which is, so it wasn't ideal. But you can see we're doing decent pound on the last. Like, the cadence doesn't stop you that much, I'd say, on one effort. Like, if I was just doing one effort full gas, like, if you slip down to 60, 65 cadence, it's fine, just because it's such a short effort, and often, like, that's the best way of doing it, because you can use your muscles a lot more and just use brute force, basically, to get up. And that's fine on one effort, but when you're doing multiple efforts, that's not good. And if you're doing a long effort, like if you're trying to do a 20-minute, half-an-hour climb, again, that's not good. So if you're doing a 2-minute effort, yeah, obviously gears is not irrelevant, but, like, they're not too important. But obviously, the longer the effort is, or if you're doing it back day after day, that's why stage racing is so important, to have cadence, because you just reduce how tired your legs get, basically. Everyone was always like, fatigue metabolites, it's basically just the hydrogen diet's coming from lactic acid, because lactic acid must be a weak acid, and then it deprotonates, and you get the H plus ions, which are basically the things that make your legs hurt a lot. But also, it just uses your legs in a lot different way compared to just spinning. There's your little science for the day, if you were wondering. Anyway, here we wait for Nicole. I can't really bother to skip because we don't actually end up waiting for that long. But you can see Mount Osmond's on the right hand side up there. That's a very nice climb. It's about 10%. And it's good. It's not not crazy steep at any part, but it's just like a solid 10-12%. I think it is for one kilometer. Yeah, apart from that, I can't remember what this road is called, but Dan Everest did it, and he did it in, I think it's the world's shortest Everest. So he did it in 92 or 99 kilometers, something like that. And he Everested that, and like it took him a very long time. I think he ended up doing 10,000 meters of climbing, which is just insane. He was on a mountain bike and had to change the pads twice on the disc brakes because they were worn so much. So I'll show you where it is. It's just coming up on the right hand side. But when I felt like it's just so steep, like it's so steep that you can't descend fast. So his average speed was something like, I don't even know, it was like 10 k's an hour maybe, I think it was 8, because he went 4 k an hour on the up and then maybe 10 or 12 on the downhill. But because it takes you so long to go up, that it doesn't really vary out. As you can see, you turn right here, and I remember the first time I sprinted up here, I was like, oh, that's it. But it's not. It ramps up a lot. The gradient is a little bit, gradient always takes a little bit of time to adjust. But you can see it's 10%, so 10%, you're like, oh, it's not too bad, but it will just keep going up to probably 16, 17. But this is horrible. I don't know how Dan did it. Like, when Dan kept telling me, like, what the Everesting he's done, like, some of them, and the same with Harley when he did that Gil Terrace, it's just, like, it's incredible. Like, when you ride these climbs, you're just like, how could anyone do it? But here, like, I'm literally 48 cadence at 340 watts on a 21% gradient, and Dan's just dancing away. It's just not even fair. Like, I just need more gears. But I should stop complaining. I should go down to Kim and North Adelaide Cycles. Sorry, oh, North Adelaide Cycles, saying it to a local. But you see, and then go get my gear fixed. So you have to hop over that, which when you're going like 9k an hour is not the most easy thing you can do. But anyway, so we keep going up, and this is where Dan Everest did. So he did basically from the bottom all the way up the top, this drive. I think it's called like Tregenza Drive. That's it. I always get confused with Tregarthen Brolas, which is a different thing. That's a different video. I'll do a quick plug. That's a 92k an hour Katusha. I'll link it in the description or somewhere. But anyway, this is a super steep climb. Absolutely horrible. Can you see how long it is though, the 20%? It's disgusting. I'm doing 40 cadence. You'll see, here we go. We start doing the old paperboy technique, as they call it in America, where you wind across the road. It does help actually a lot, to be honest. But it's not very efficient because you're covering way more distance. But it's absolutely disgusting. This climb is like 40 cadence. I genuinely don't think I could go faster just because the cadence is so low. You're like the equivalent power if I was at 90 cadence would probably be like 500 or 600 watts. That's the sort of thing you're talking about because it's just such a low cadence. And finally, you get to the top, and it flattens off a little bit. But again, descending this is not, you can't rail it like 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 k's an hour, which you could if it was like a longer part of the descent. Instead, you have to take it relatively careful because there's a road at the bottom where you turn by the roundabout tree thing. And there's also, so there's Nicole coming up. She was doing very well, actually. She also had super easy gears, which I should have had because she had a 34, 36, which is like, ugh. Would have been very dreamy. But yeah, she got some QOMs or whatever, which is pretty beautiful. I think I got a couple top 10s and then got knocked out by Dan, or I don't understand. They said I got two top 11. They said I got two top 10s and then they both ended up being 11. But you can see here, like 20% gradient, like I'm going 18 k's an hour down here. I mean, obviously I could go faster, but I don't really want to crash or anything. And then you have to drop down this part here, so you can't really go that fast. And then again here, we're turning right, so you can't go that fast again. But yeah, we're coming to the end of the video. That was absolutely disgusting descents. There's more of this. I'll upload it in the last couple of days. So yeah, cheers for watching. I hope you enjoyed my sufferfest and my low cadence gains. So yeah, I'll see you in the next video.